Hi everyone, welcome to another edition of Token Topics, a channel all about crypto and blockchain. I hope everyone out there is doing great. Topic of this video is Hedera Hashgraph. We're going to dive in and see if this is a good investment or not. Hedera has been a project I've been keeping on my radar for some time, and there's a lot of big names that are part of the governing council, which tells me exactly where it's going. It's going up. So if you're wanting to learn more about this project, you've come to the right spot. Please hit the like and subscribe if you do like the content. And remember, I'm not a financial advisor. Any investing is risky, so please be smart, safe, do it at your own risk, always do more research, and also I'm not paid for or sponsored by Hedera Hashgraph. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into the content.
We are in the dawn of a new decentralized era, where people who don't know or trust each other can securely collaborate and transact online without the need for an intermediary. For distributed ledgers to go mainstream and enable this vision, there are four issues that must be addressed: speed, security, stability, and governance. Hedera Hashgraph is the enterprise-grade public network that addresses these challenges. The underlying Hashgraph consensus algorithm offers speed and scalability, fair ordering, and best-in-class security for mission-critical applications. Hedera is a platform built on and built for trust.
You need a governing concept. And because blockchain systems are about trust, well, somebody has to set the standard for trust.
Hedera aims to achieve a truly decentralized governance model. The Hedera Governing Council is an elected group of highly diversified, leading global organizations committed to supporting the development and growth of the Hedera public network. Comprised of the world's most innovative companies across different industries and geographies, the Hedera Governing Council will chart the path for the Hedera platform and public network. Their responsibilities include hosting and maintaining initial network nodes, establishing a governance framework for global markets, and overseeing the software run by hundreds of thousands of nodes at scale, and for the overall direction of the Hedera platform's code base.
We decided to join Hedera Hashgraph, but not only join, but being a counselor on the Hedera Hashgraph network, because it's important for us to influence the future roadmap.
The Governing Council will play a crucial role for this emerging sector, creating the best practices and guidelines that will serve the industry for decades to come.
But we're all going to be able to get together and share that sort of global best practice knowledge on a series of interesting and challenging questions about the future of this technology and how we can help frame a governance around it.
Hedera Hashgraph goes beyond blockchain. With a fast, fair, and secure distributed public ledger governed by the world's leading enterprises and made for developers, creating a trusted and empowered digital future for all.
As you can see right there, that video speaks volumes. The governing council members are pretty big names. You got IBM and Google, Boeing, and so forth. And so that tells me that the ecosystem is going to be very professional. It's going to be high grade, and it's going to be enterprise ready. I mean, it's probably going to be a top five crypto, in my personal opinion. All right, so Hedera is not like traditional blockchain. It is designed to be fair, more efficient system that eliminates some of the limitations that older blockchain-based platforms faced. And the Hbar token has a dual role with the Hedera public network. First and foremost, Hbar fuels and powers the Hedera services such as smart contracts, file storage, and regular transactions. Second, it's used to help secure the network since Hbar users can stake their tokens to assist with maintaining the integrity of the platform. Hedera has two founders, Dr. Lehman Baird and Mance Harmon. I'll put the link to this CoinMarketCap link down below so you can go through it and read it yourself. The price of Hbar right now, it's down, and so that's always a good opportunity. So right there, it's a little over 25 cents. Now, me personally, not financial advice, but personally, I like to dollar cost average. So during times like this just by little by little. I think one of the greatest regrets that people are going to have in the crypto space is not holding any Hbar. And let me explain. Like, for example, myself, that I have three positions where they're my main part of my portfolio, right? Well, it's not Hbar. Sadly to say, it's not Hbar because I've already made a commitment to those three. So, but I will say that this is definitely one I'm adding to my portfolio, and it's one that I'm going to be dollar cost averaging, especially taking advantage of dips like this. But I think that one of the greatest regrets that people are ever going to have is not holding any Hbar. I think that's kind of ridiculous, and you're going to see why more in this video.
Pleased to say I'm joined by Limon Baird, the inventor of the Hashgraph algorithm. He's all at Hedera. Thank you so much for joining us, Limon. It's so good to have you on the program. Let me ask you, first of all, in the simplest way possible, for those watching at home who are thinking, what are we talking about? Explain why the environmental cost of cryptocurrencies is so high.
So it's great that Bitcoin gives people the ability to have a decentralized money that they can spend without banks or anyone else in between, but it uses a lot of electricity, more than all of Ireland every year. And so this is not as green as you would like. And so we have Hedera Hashgraph that uses much more than 5 million times less, according to the University College of London report.
So will the environmental cost eventually decrease when we're using more renewable energy for these purposes?
No, because you're using renewable energies that could have been used for something else. The best kind of energy usage is the energy you don't use.
So we can see that Hedera is really taken on the global stage right now and has caught the attention of a lot of big heads right there. And also, the green initiative is perfect fit for Hedera. All right, so Hedera is owned and governed by the world's leading organizations. And as you can see here, some major names. Major names. You got IBM, Google, LG, Boeing, Standard Bank. I mean, it just keeps going. A big one that I like here is IBM partnership. We know that IBM has Hyperledger Fabric. So with all the use cases of that blockchain and partner with Hedera, I'm just wondering if all the use cases that are going to come out in the future. And this was some major news that came out last year. This is great news. So Google and IBM among those supporting the Hedera token service launch. I'm going to put the article down below, the link to this. So with its live token service, there's 60 plus, probably much more than that, 60 plus partners, including those from the governing council. And you have IBM and Google. So you have Google Cloud and also IBM as part of the governing council. So not only are they governing council, but also they're going to utilize token services. All right, let's hear some words from Limon about the token service.
So this is our webinar about the token service. We are announcing this. We are excited about it. And we have over 60 plus ecosystem partners already for this tokenization thing. We just want to tell you something about it today. So let's get into it. Let's see what this tokenization thing is. Now, you know, the vision of Hedera from the beginning has been to build a trusted, secure, and empowered digital future for all. And we really do mean all these things, that it will be trusted. Trust is the keystone of this whole thing, and empower you to build a digital future for everybody. We want everyone around the world in every kind of country to be able to participate in this new future. And so we want people to be able to create things and to be able to trust how they're interacting and how these things are operating, and to be able to have real things of value that they've created that they are transferable. And so we want to be able to support all of that. So the idea is that anyone can at any time carve out a piece of cyberspace for themselves and create new things, create tokens, but create other things too, just all kinds of things. And then to invite others to share with them. And so all the people can get together and be sharing. They can be sharing the things you create, playing games together, listening to things, consuming media together. You can then invite other people and they can join you, and they can also see what you're creating and help to create and interact with you socially and economically and in every possible way. And then the idea is that you have your little group doing these things, your piece of cyberspace, but there are others. And so we have all of these other pieces connected. So everybody is creating value, and we can transfer that value back and forth. And if we can do that, then if it is fast and fair and secure, it creates a new kind of world, a world where we really do have cyberspace empowering people to do everything. But it's got to be fast, fair, and secure. And of course, because we are doing tokenization, I mean, because we are creating things of value, we need to be able to transfer it, which means we need tokenization. So hello future, hello tokenization. Okay, what we are doing is in Hedera, we've had this virtuous cycle. You have the ledger that has data integrity. You know that what you do with your files there are stored forever and until you delete them, but they're stored when they should be. That what has happened is an immutable record that you can always see on the mirror nodes and no one can change that. That you can create things, you can send back and forth HBARs, and all of this, like the data integrity, helps support decentralized identity. So you can do things pseudonymously if you want, but you can also do things with identity. And then that helps the creation of value and the transfer of value.
All right, that's a long video, but I'm going to put the link to that video down below. But that gives us a better understanding that Hedera is much more than just a cryptocurrency. It's much more. All right, so now somebody might ask, well, where is their headquarters at? So we can see here that Hedera Hashgraph is headquartered in Richardson, Texas. So it's a U.S.-based company. Also, I'll put the link to this down below. This is Hedera Papers, so you can look at the white paper if you'd like. So you can see right there the white paper, the vision, the mission, and hello future. All right, so now somebody might be asking, where could they purchase HBAR? Pretty much every major exchange I know, Binance, BitTrue, Gemini, you can probably also purchase it for many different wallets. And Coinbase has not decided to list it yet, but I do say yet. That is probably going to be coming in the future. All right, so now let's go ahead and look at the total supply, circulating supply. So the circulating supply is just under 20 billion HBAR. The total supply is 50 billion. And so we see the price right now. It's just over 25 cents. Not financial advice, but as I stated, what I'd like to personally do is dollar cost average. And I think that these dips that we're seeing in the market right now are the perfect opportunity to add. We can see that it's ranked number 34. I do not doubt, after hearing all this information about Hedera, and I'm sure there's a lot more, too much to cover in this video. After researching all this, I believe that this is definitely going to be a top 5 project. Yes, a top 5. As far as price goes, I don't like to go too much into price speculations. But I will say this, within the coming few years, I would say in the next 3 years, I definitely see this as being maybe around a $5 to $10 asset. Probably a lot more, especially with institutional money and mainstream adoption coming in. Probably a lot more. All right. Before I end the video, I'd like to show how the algorithm works and how it's different from other algorithms.
Hello. I'd like to talk to you about how the Hashgraph consensus algorithm works. Suppose we have a bunch of computers, we'll imagine 8, that are named Alice through Hank. So Alice has a transaction she wants to send out. She puts it inside of a message, and that message she sends out by using a gossip protocol. This means she sends it to a random person, and then each of them sends it to a random person, and they send it to a random person, and exponentially fast it explodes outwards and the whole world knows about it. Now what if Bob and Carol have transactions they want to send? Well, they put them inside of messages, which they then send out to random people. So there are 2, then 4, then 8, and it blows up exponentially. But how do we know what time each message reached the world as a whole? Well, we could keep track of when each person received each message, and we could take those times, and we could sort them, all the times for the red message, and so on, and then we could take the middle of the list. This tells you when the red message reached most of the world, and when the blue one did, and when the green one did. And if we sort the messages by that, that puts them into a fair order. So now we have them in order. Oh, but wait, how do we know when each person received each message? Sounds like you'd have to send out a lot of receipts. No, we'll send no receipts at all. Here's how. When we're doing our talking, we can draw this graph of how we talk to each other. Alice talked to Dave, so we draw a line from Alice to Dave, and then they talked, and we have 2 more lines, and then more, and then the blue and the green come into our graph, and then they spread and spread and spread. And the result is this big diagram of how we've all talked to each other, this graph. But we could create a message for every circle in the graph. It has whatever transactions you want to create. It has a timestamp of when you're claiming that you're creating it. It has your digital signature, and it includes two hashes. A cryptographic hash of the last message you made and the last message you received. And just by adding the two hashes, it ties them all together. And so we could actually store this graph in memory on every computer, and we would all know the complete history of how we talk to each other. We're not just gossiping the transactions. We are actually gossiping out indirectly this graph itself. We're gossiping about the gossip. We are actually talking about how we're talking. And once we all have this hash graph in memory, we can just look at it and do virtual voting, which means we just look at it and we know the timestamp of when each person received each message. We don't have to talk to each other about it. We don't have to send out additional messages about when you received things and about what orders to put things in. You get it for free. Virtual voting. So, how does Hashgraph consensus work? We want to put the transactions in order. How do we do that? We'll sort them by the order of the events. But what's the order of the events? You just sort them by the consensus timestamp for each of these events. But what's the consensus timestamp on an event? It'll be the median of the received time. It'll be the middle of all those times of when it reached everybody in the world. What's the received time? Well, it's when an active computer, an active node, received it. The computers that around that time were each sending events to many of the other nodes. But what do we mean at that time, sent events, too many? Well, we mean during that round. We all have this history in the hash graph. We break up history into a bunch of rounds, and we just look at it and say, okay, during that round, did this node actually send out some events? If they did, they have a famous witness. And did it reach many people at once? If they did, we call that witness famous. And we will weight all of this virtual voting by the stake that they are holding, how many Hbars they own. So, it is gossip about gossip, with virtual voting, and that is the Hashgraph consensus algorithm.
Keep your crypto safe with a decent biometric wallet from IoTrust. Buy it through Token Topics and receive a $10 off coupon. I am affiliated with Decent Wallet, and I personally use them myself, and I do enjoy the wallet. Well, everyone, what are your thoughts on Hedera Hashgraph? Go ahead and comment down below. I want to say thank you for watching the video, and I hope you have a great one.